see your participating Lennox dealer for details. Lennox dealers include independently owned and operated businesses. Lennox. A better place.
Cornerstone Ag is committed to the Northwest Kansas community because they're proud to be a part of it. At Cornerstone Ag, the staff works hard to be your local answer to all of your grain storage and handling needs, as well as a great local marketing resource. Their service is fast and friendly, with questions being answered on-site by their professionals. During non-peak times, they can even assist you with pickup and delivery services. Cornerstone Ag, where local customer service is not just a priority, it's the only way they'll do business.
Hi, this is Jackie from Farmers and Merchants Bank of Colby. We could have the key to unlock your dreams. Mortgage interest rates are still at an all-time low, and it isn't too late for you to take advantage of this opportunity. This could be the time you've been waiting for to lower your monthly payments or to purchase a new home. Give me a call today at 785-460-3321 while rates are still low. Together, making a difference. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Farm Credit Western Kansas and Colby has once again returned $2.5 million of patronage to its members. In just the past 10 years alone, we have put nearly $20 million back into the area economy. At Farm Credit, we are proud to be the area's leading ag lender, taking an active interest in the success of our borrower owners. If you're involved in agriculture and not a Farm Credit member, why not? Call us at 1-800-657-6048 to find out the difference it makes being an owner. Farm Credit Western Kansas, financing ag for generations.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back. 73-39, the final score tonight. Hoxie gets the win over Colby. You're listening to the Farmers and Merchants Bank postgame show and the Eagles on radio here on 100.3 The Line. Senior night tonight here in Colby, so the seniors being recognized for the winter sports athletes. And that's getting ready to take place here. In between ball games, Colby with a, we talked about this going in. It's going to be a tough effort tonight against Hoxie, a very good basketball team. We talked about the start of the game being very important because Hoxie, a very, quick, good starting basketball team. And really, it kind of turned out that way tonight. The first quarter was a killer for the Eagles, and then after that, settled down and played okay. In the game, we outscored by 22 in the first quarter, 27-5. Outscored by 1 in the second quarter, 7 in the third, and 4 in the fourth. So we combined just 12 points after that opening quarter. So one of those where, again, the starts are so important in these games, especially against good teams.
Oh, absolutely. You take a well-disciplined, great, coached team like Hoxie. When you get down by that kind of deficit in the first quarter, it's almost impossible to come back from. But like you said, after that, they really settled down, played good basketball, and really looked pretty good here tonight.
Well, that's the thing what you look at in a game like this. Again, you get down to a team like this, you're not going to make a run and come back.
No.
It's going to be very, very, very tough to do. But if you can hang in there for three quarters, you never know what's going to happen at the end of the ball game if you can just hang in.
Mm-hmm.
Again, we did that. Just that first quarter was a killer tonight. Run through scoring in the ball game for Hoxie. They were led by Carly Hine. Tremendous effort for Hine tonight. 24 points in the game. Lynn Niblock with 13 points on the night for the Indians. 15 points for Taryn Hoyt in the game as well. Serena McCown with 9 points in the game. Lexi Schamberger ended the night with 6 points. Aaron Carter also with 6 points tonight for the Indians. For Colby, they were led by Hannah Strange. Good game for Hannah tonight. 12 points for Strange, the 5'10 senior on senior night. That's a good one for the Lady Eagles. So 12 points for Strange in the game. 9 points for Kelly Sloan tonight. 6 points for Haley Schindler in the game. Shayla Gieber ends the night with 3. Brenda Terrell with 5. All of them coming in the third quarter. 3 points for Brielle McKee tonight and 1 for Courtney Van Eaton. We'll run through rebounding in the game for the two teams now.
Hoxie's led by Carly Hine with 7. Lexi Schamberger, 6. Bryn Niblock, 2. Lara Stevens and Kelsey Gertis, 1 apiece. Colby's led by Hannah Strange with 5. Shayla Gieber, 3. Bailey Fox, Kelly Sloan, Haley Schindler, 2. Brielle McKee and Brindley Terrell, one rebound apiece. That'll do it for rebounding, and we'll take a short break and be back here with the rest of the postgame show.
It's time someone stood up for breakfast, the meal that sets the tone for your entire day. Hey, a soy latte isn't breakfast. Toasted pastry from a vending machine aren't either. Fluffy scrambled eggs, sizzling sausage, bacon. This is breakfast. And this is what's in Taco John's breakfast burritos, along with nacho cheese and golden potato relays, wrapped up like scrambled sunshine. They're the best breakfast burritos in town, only at Taco John's.
Taco John's!
The one-stop shopping in Colby, Kansas, don't forget about Colby's Walmart. Walmart in Colby has a great selection of grocery items in the store. From meat to macaroni, they've got it in the grocery department of Walmart. And, of course, all the latest movies on DVD or Blu-ray, as well as your favorite PlayStation or Wii games. Walmart in Colby also has clothes, dog food, and, of course, the pharmacy there to serve you as well. Walmart of Colby, proud to be part of the community and proud to support local high school student-athletes. For all your one-stop shopping, it's Walmart in Colby.
Well, the days may be gradually getting longer, but the weather's going to be colder. A lot of winter left, and at Plum Creek Limited, they have a lot of fashions, a lot of savings to keep you warm. At Plum Creek, you'll find unique savings for men's suits and casual wear, missy and women's dress and casual clothing. Remember, for upcoming weddings, tuxedos by Jim Formal Wear, they're available for rent, as well as your bridal registry is at Plum Creek Limited in downtown Colby. You sure look unique when you shop at Plum Creek in downtown.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, now with Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby. As part of the team at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic, I will not only be there to serve you in all your chiropractic needs, but will also be able to improve your health and well-being with acupuncture and Grafton technique. It's not commonly known that acupuncture doesn't just help with back pain. Acupuncture can help with many ailments, like infertility, arthritis, sinus issues, and allergies. I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, inviting you to come see me at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby and start feeling better today.
Physical ailments and injuries are a red light on the road of life. Dina Harris Physical Therapy can turn those painful red lights green, allowing you to move forward with life. Free screenings for pain and injury, sports medicine, hand therapy, post-surgery therapy, all offered by Dina Harris Physical Therapy. And this is just a small sampling of the services they offer. If it has to do with bringing you back to health and enjoying normal everyday life, chances are Dina Harris Physical Therapy can help. And they work with most insurance companies. Turn painful red lights back to green with Tina Harris Physical Therapy on Franklin in downtown Colby.
Hello, this is J.L. Evans, President of Western State Bank in Colby. We are a full-service bank with innovative products that you expect from your financial institution. We specialize in excellent customer service and competitive ag, commercial, and home loans. Check us out by calling, stopping by, or I will gladly come to your final place of business for your convenience. We are located just southeast of the Colby Walmart, right next door to the Utterly Delicious Yogurt Shop. Western State Bank of Colby, with bank locations throughout western Kansas. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back. Final score tonight, 73-39. Hoxie gets the win over Colby. Action at the Colby Community Building tonight. You're listening to the Farmers and Merchants Bank postgame show. The Eagles on radio here on 100.3 The Ride. A big thank you to our postgame sponsor, Farmers and Merchants Bank. Of course, where they make banking simple and easy for you at Farmers and Merchants Bank. They have, of course, their online banking. They have the mobile banking. You can do that there on your smartphone. Plus two locations to better serve you, with the main bank downtown and the branch location at Dillon's. And again, extra hours and time to better serve you. See them today at Farmers and Merchants Bank, member FDIC. They bring you our postgame show tonight here on 100.3 The Ride, as the Eagles again came out short 73-39 to Hoxie, despite a hard-fought effort by the Lady Eagles in this game tonight. And Thomas, one of those, and now we got a rebound and look at here. We got one more warm-up game, you could say, on the year coming up on Friday. They'll be on the road taking on Ulysses. There's a pretty solid basketball team in a game that Colby wants to get a win in this one to get them set up and ready for the end of this and headed into sub-state. Need something positive at the end of the year.
Yeah, it's always great to go into sub-state with the win. You know, get some momentum on your side, whatever momentum you can stretch out for 5 days. They got to play. They got to stretch after Friday. Come in Thursday night here, play TNT. But you just got to. You've got that game Friday. Get some kinks out. You know, use it as a warm up. Get a better look than what you're going to get into a practice. Then you got 5 days after that, and that's all you got to iron everything out. And then you got 2 days to extend your postseason. After that, you got 2 games.
And, of course, as we talked about the sub-state brackets, it appears as though Colby most likely going to have TMP on Thursday night, 7:30 here at the community building. You're all welcome to attend that and cheer on the Eagles. 73-39, the final score. We'll take a break back with more coming up in a couple of minutes. You're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby basketball on 100.3 The Rhine.
It's time for Colby High School basketball.
Quality workmanship and experience are just two of the things you will find when working with Stevens Construction for all your agricultural, commercial, and residential construction needs. They are your local Butler and Muster dealer and are ready to assist you in choosing the steel or wood frame building you have been looking for. They also specialize in overhead door sales and service. Stevens Construction has been in the business for over 40 years, so stop by today and see them on South Country Club Drive in Colby. Since 1994, Office Works and Home Furnishings in Colby has been offering solutions for your home and office needs. And while they still continue to do that, they also specialize in something else. Comfort. Office Works and Home Furnishings is a proud retailer of the Serta I Comfort beds with optional adjustable bases. Plus, on top of that, they're the only Lazy Boy Comfort Studio in Northwest Kansas. So if you're looking to make your home more comfortable this year, make sure you stop by Office Works and Home Furnishings on South Range in Colby.
With High Plains Co-op, it's great to know that the more things change, the more things stay the same. High Plains Co-op, with locations in Hoxie, Dresden, Rainfield, Jim, Halford, Park, Sylvan, and in Levant, they're here to give you the service you deserve. High Plains Co-op is available for your grain, fuel, and feed needs. Check out their website at highplainscoop.com for up-to-date markets. Standing with you, it's High Plains Co-op.
This time of year, you'll be doing more traveling, loading up and heading out in the family truckster. Make sure you get to your destination safely. A Great Western Tire of Oakley and Colby. We have a tire sale going on now with Goodyear car, pickup, and truck tires. You'll find a tread and tire time for the way you drive, either down the highway or on country roads. At Great Western Tire, they offer service well after the sale, like free tire rotation. So take advantage of the Goodyear and other name brand tires on sale. Plus their appliance sale going on now at Great Western Tire of Oakley and Colby.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby basketball on 100.3 The Rhine. It's senior night continuing here at the Colby Community Building. We'll get set for the men's game against Hoxie coming up a little bit later on here. Hoxie, solid men's team on the year, 13-6 overall. Coming into the game tonight, and they played some tough opponents in there. Won the league tournament. Again, a very capable basketball team as well. And Colby's going to have a pretty good game tonight to come out of this one. They're going to be really watching a couple of the seniors for Hoxie in this game. You got Ewers, who's averaging 13 points per game on the season, and then Kato, who is averaging 17.1 per game on the season, coming into the contest. There's a couple of really solid players, and then of course Heim with 7 and Slipke with 6. So again, this is a team well-rounded. They've got a lot of kids that can score, and they will play hard tonight here, and it's one of those that Colby come out and does the best they can. They've got a chance to win in this one, but they're going to have to play hard to get a victory here tonight. And senior night stuff is wrapped up here as the parents and senior athletes leaving the floor here and getting hugs and congratulations from some of the other kids out here, and then we can get on to the men's warm-up, which is what we're waiting on here. We'll also talk to the head coach of the Lady Eagles, Ryan Becker, and get his thoughts on the game in just a couple of minutes. But of course, he wanted to participate on senior night with his group. He had 5 seniors on this Eagle team this year, and going to leave some good players. Hannah Strange, senior for Colby, who led him in scoring tonight. Shayla Gieber, Haley Schimmer, Kelly Sloan, and Darby Sager, all seniors for the Lady Eagles, and all capable players that have contributed to this program in one form or another throughout their 4 years here at Colby High School. And so they will all be a group of kids that will be definitely missed. But
On the other side of it for Colby, we've talked about it throughout the year, lots and lots of youth on this Eagle team, and the future looks great, and there's some good kids coming up on the middle school side of things as well. Boys team for Colby with some seniors as well. Caleb Masnick, Ezekiel Baca, Aaron Faber, Chase Eggert, Josh Brown, Austin and Ashton Russ, and Dylan Dunlop. So quite a few kids will be moving on the men's side of things for Colby headed into next year. So anyway, getting the floor cleared off. And then we'll get set for this men's game, which will start about 20 minutes from now. We'll go ahead and take another break. Come back with more of our pregame show after a word from our sponsors. You're listening to the Eagles on the Radio and Colby Basketball on 100.3 The Ride.
Be ready for whatever tasks lie ahead with a Case IH Maxim tractor from Colby Ag Center in Colby. Thanks to multiple engine, horsepower, and transmission choices, plus great options, you'll be ready to handle anything from tending the livestock to roadside mowing. But even as different as each Case IH Maxim tractor can be, there's one thing that makes them all the same, and that's their exclusive efficient power and proven SCR technology for greater fuel efficiency with lower emissions. See Colby Ag Center about a Case IH Maxim tractor today.
It's Ram Truck Month at Colby Dodge, and we are extending the Truck Month savings to you. If you're in the market for a new Ram truck, you can save up to $9,000 off MSRP this month at Colby Dodge. We also would like to invite you to test drive the all-new 2015 Chrysler 200 and take advantage of 0% financing up to 60 months with approved credit. Visit us in person at exit 53I-70, Colby, Kansas, or online at ColbyDodge.com.
You come in, we change your oil, check your tires, wipers and bulbs, everything your owner's manual recommends. We got expert technicians who all know how. People keep their cars much longer now, so maintenance is a much bigger deal. So let us take care of your automobile. Count on Kansas Quick Lube. Our name says it all.
Find the perfect home with Homeland Realty at Auction. Growing up, you didn't care if your home was small or the curtains were old. The important things about home were sneaking in bed with mom and dad during a thunderstorm, licking beaters when you made chocolate cake, and playing hide and seek in the backyard. Now, even though you care about things like square footage, decor, and neutral colors, you want to buy a home that gives you all the good feelings of the one you grew up in. The home where you walk in the front door and that little voice inside you says, this is the one. Visit Homeland Realty and Auction in Colby or Green.
Now, with more of the Eagles on Radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Whelan.
Welcome back. Pre-game underway now. Colby and Hoxie on the men's side of things. You're listening to the Strut Insurance Services pre-game show and the Eagles on Radio on 100.3 The Ride, brought to you by Strut Insurance Services. There for all of your insurance needs. Stop by and see Darvin and his crew today at Strut Insurance Services, and Strut your stop at Strut Insurance Services. They bring you our pregame show tonight here on 100.3 The Ride as the Eagles on the floor going through the pregame warm-up here with the Hoxie Indians in their side here, trying to get a victory over Hoxie tonight. And Colby still looking for the elusive first win of the season, coming off of a very tough game against Hugoton, although they did some things okay in that game. You know, it was one of those that, you know, Hugoton had handled them really easily the first time they played, but it was a lot better effort for Colby the second time out, and I thought there were some times in the second half where they were a little more patient, did some things with the basketball, and hung in that game for a while. I thought the effort wasn't bad at all for Colby up to the last minute or two of the game. I thought played pretty well now, so we'll see if we can keep that same effort going into the game tonight and take care of the ball. You never know what's going to happen. But going to have to take care of the basketball again. Hoxie, a team that's won some games, and they have confidence coming in here.
Yeah, that's one thing you gotta look at here. You know, you expect the press coming out. Colby hasn't handled that press well. But you come out here, you value the ball, keep the possessions down, really try and work the ball around, get some offensive looks down low, and try not to rely. You know, sometimes Colby gets into a, you know, one and done type of offense. You know, really try and work the ball around. The three is open, take it. But just value the ball offensively and defensively. Just make them shoot. Don't let them get down to the paint. Make them hit it from the outside.
Talk more about this one as the pregame show continues. Again, Colby and Hoxie going head-to-head tonight. We'll look at some scores from some of the earlier games tonight, last ones that we had in. Goodwin defeated Scott City in girls play tonight, 52-20, the final in that one. Hugoton was leading Holcomb at the start of the fourth quarter, 57-46. Have not seen a final on that ball game yet tonight. And again, Colby coming up short, 73-39, to Hoxie, the final score of the women's game this evening. Again, we'll talk to the coach of the Eagles, Ryan Becker, coming up a little bit later on this evening before the start of this men's game. Take a break. Come back with more of the pregame show. Thanks to Strata Insurance Services. After this word from our sponsors, you're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby Basketball on 100.3 to Ryan.
When it comes to insuring your home, vehicles, and valuables, don't just insure your stuff, strut your stuff. With Strut Insurance Services of Colby, located just west of Casey's Convenience Store and their store in Brewster. See their ad in the next Tech Directory.
A service oil company for Vincent Court and Colby, they tried to come up with a snappy jingle to tell you they're more than a regular gas station. It just didn't turn out well.
Service Oil in Colby has gas products and farm diesel and kerosene and solvents and some snacks inside.
Find some of the lowest gas prices around at Service Oil Company, along with kerosene, farm diesel, and solvents. Come inside, too, for a great selection of drinks and snacks.
Tell them about the hours.
8 to noon and 1 to 5 weekdays. And pay at the pump 24-7 at Service Oil Company, Vincent Court, Colby.
With spring around the corner, there is no better time than now to head into the sports shop in Colby and get yourself set for the spring sports season. Travis, of course, has everything you'll need, from spikes to thrower shoes for the tracksters to the bats, balls, gloves, and cleats for the baseball and softballers. Plus, going on all March is his March Mayhem Sale, where they've got great deals on everything, plus a portion of the money goes to benefit the American Heart. So make sure you stop by and get set for your spring sports season today at the sports shop in Colby.
Farming and ranching isn't just your livelihood, it's your life. No one understands that better than Farm Bureau. As the number one farm insurer in our territory, we offer comprehensive coverage that protects your farm and ranch, your machinery, your livestock, even your home and cars. We make it simple to get customized coverage in one policy, with one premium and one deductible, when you need it most. Contact Farm Bureau agent Bernard Hurd in St. Francis to see how he can help protect your bottom line.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back. Joined by the head coach now, the Lady Eagles, Coach Becker. And Coach, very good team from Hoxie tonight. We were looking at this and looking at scoring in the quarters tonight. The first quarter was a tough one, where you outscored by 22. But you look at it, second quarter, outscored by 1, 7 in the third, and 4 in the fourth. So 12 points was a difference after that first quarter. And it goes back to that, we got to play four quarters of the game. Just kind of got off to a slow start.
There were a lot of good things that we did. Unfortunately, we came out playing with an intensity that we couldn't match. And it wasn't any fault of our kids. We just couldn't hit a shot. Mm-hmm. You know, defensively speaking, we were in position most of the time. And when we hit shots, we move our feet. When we move our feet, we make stops. When we make stops, we can go back down and hit our shot. And we didn't hit a shot. You know, the rest of the game, we played fairly well. We moved some people around. We did some things differently. You know, we had to, you know, Burrell got hurt. Hopefully it's nothing serious. You know, we'll find out more later with that. But, you know, Coach and I were sitting there during senior introductions and figures and stuff out. And I looked at him, and he looked at me, and we're okay. Yeah, you know what, we're 8-11, and that's fine, you know, but we're okay. And, you know what, we'll get ready to go to practice tomorrow and get ready to do this.
And here's the thing, I mean, this group hasn't peaked by any stretch yet.
No.
They've been getting better, but they've been getting better on a weekly basis.
Yeah,
what you're looking for.
So you're saying we haven't peaked yet, Chad?
No,
we haven't, and I agree. And we haven't. You know what, the day that we play defense as well as we do for four quarters, and the day that we hit our shots, you know, it's, it's coming. It's coming. You know, it'll be next week at this time when I'm talking to you about, you know, getting ready to play two games Friday and Saturday, and that's when you need to do it. And we'll be ready for it.
Yeah, and in the sub-state brackets, not officially released yet, but you're going to have TMP.
Yeah.
What is it, Thursday at 7:30?
Friday, Saturday. Boys play on Thursday. So, yeah, we'll be the late game depending on when Concordia decides they want to play, if they want to play it earlier, because they get to dictate the time due to their distance. And it'll be two good basketball games. And the best team playing the best ball at the right time, you know, gets to go to Wichita. And that's the neat thing about high school sports and sports in general. You know, you work all season to see an end result, and that's what we're working for.
So if you look at it here down the stretch, you have Ulysses on Friday yet to go. What do you look for in that game? What do you got to get out of that game to get you ready?
There's a couple specific things that we need to do offensively, and there's a couple specific things we need to do versus the press. We're a lot better off than anybody that's listening on the radio right now thinks we are. And that's fine, because we know in the locker room that we're going to be okay. And we do a couple things the next 2 days of practice and hop on a bus and go down to Ulysses and roll up our sleeves and go to work, and then we'll be ready for next week.
And I thought, the first two possessions were turnovers out of that press. But after that, I thought you guys settled down and did pretty well.
Well, we're a team that has a hard time finishing. Everybody knows it, and if I was scouting us, that'd be the first thing I'd tell the kids that we're playing against Colby, is they have a hard time finishing, just keep a body in front of them. But you know what? The second half, we did a hell of a lot better job of finishing.
Yep.
And at least being aggressive enough to make shots, to take shots. You know, so with that being said, they're going to fall. And when they start falling, we're going to be nasty to stop.
Yeah, because it's going to open some things up. You look at the last two of your last three games, Anna's led you in scoring underneath, which is what you've kind of been looking for to open the outside.
We've been working on trying to get more post presence, and we did that the second half. We just, unfortunately, just didn't get enough of that in the first half and too many turnovers again that got us too far behind for us to work on the things we really needed to do to be successful. So, you know what, like I said, we're going to go back to work tomorrow, because this season is far but over for us.
Yep, we've got a lot to go.
Yep.
Coach, we appreciate your time.
Thank you, Chuck.
Coach Becker of the Colby Eagles, back with more of the pregame show coming up here in just a minute. You're listening to the Eagles on the radio and Colby Basketball 100.3 The Rock.
The Country Flooring and Cabinetry here in Northwest Kansas, the place to go is Northwest Kansas Decorating Center. They've been in business for over 39 years, serving the Northwest Kansas community with all their flooring and cabinetry needs. With many different types of flooring to choose from and cabinetry that allows you to pick your different wood and stain combinations, plus, of course, all the accessories to make it functional for you. See them today. Northwest Kansas Decorating Center, located on West 4th Street in Colby, for all of your flooring and cabinetry needs today. And while you're there, say, hi, Mr. Carey Turner.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, now with Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby. As part of the team at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic, I will not only be there to serve you in all your chiropractic needs, but will also be able to improve your health and well-being with acupuncture and Grafton technique. The Grafton technique breaks down scar tissue, helps in faster rehabilitation, and treats chronic conditions like joint pain, plantar fasciitis, and fibromyalgia. I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, inviting you to come see me at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby and start feeling better
it's
today.
It's too hot! It's too cold! Sound familiar?
If your thermostat roars and your utility bills soaring, see your Lennox dealer about a Dave Lennox Signature Collection home comfort system.
Visit your local Dave Lennox Premier dealer, McKee Incorporated, located on South Range, right here in Colby.
See your participating Lennox dealer for details. Lennox dealers include independently owned and operated businesses. Lennox. A better place.
Cornerstone Ag is committed to the Northwest Kansas community because they're proud to be a part of it. At Cornerstone Ag, the staff works hard to be your local answer to all of your grain storage and handling needs, as well as a great local marketing resource. Their service is fast and friendly, with questions being answered on-site by their professionals. During non-peak times, they can even assist you with pickup and delivery services. Cornerstone Ag, where local customer service is not just a priority, it's the only way they'll do business.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby Basketball 100.3 The Ride. Again, the Strut Insurance Services pregame shows. We're about 8.5 minutes away from tip-off of Colby and Hoxie tonight. Hoxie is kind of been a change in their school a little bit. You talk about a perennial powerhouse on the wrestling side of things for so many years, and the state championships that they won there. And look at it this year, I think they were down to three kids on the wrestling team headed into the season this year, and the basketball team, again, going for a second or third year in a row, where they've been really good on the men's side of things. So kind of how it goes sometimes, and I wouldn't just say in the smaller schools, it happens in schools our size. Colby, it used to be a good basketball school here, and recently on the men's side, it's been wrestling, although the wrestling's been good all the way through for the Eagles as well. But kind of interesting with Hoxie. I can remember doing state tournaments of 3-2-1A, and pretty much the entire town of Hoxie just shut down and go out and watch the kids play, watch the kids wrestle, because they'd be bringing their whole team to the state tournament. And it was always a lot of fun. It was great to watch them. Had a little section they set in and got loud and rowdy, and now they're doing it on the basketball side. They've been loud and rowdy tonight. Great crowd has made the short trip from Hoxie over here for this game this evening, and sitting again here at the community building. Quite a few kids here. I'm glad to see that they brought these matchups back. We kind of go back to the old Northwest Kansas League, where these games used to take place every year. And, of course, you get the home and homes each year. But now, it's been a long time, really, since we've had these matchups with Hoxie and Oakley. Yeah. And to get these back in there, I like this working back into the schedule. I think it's good for both schools.
It really is. You bring a team in like Hoxie, they're down in the size of the school in a few years, but they still play a great basketball on both sides. So you bring that in here, you get that rivalry back. It's tough because you're Northwest Kansas League for so long, then you switch to GWAC, and those rivalries aren't really the same. You still got Goodland. We still don't like them. They don't like us. You still got
them. That'll never change.
No.
But, it is what it is. But, yeah, it's fun to get some of these old rivalry games back again. We're not going to see it in football anymore, as a lot of the schools have gone to 8-man now. So basketball is really only the time outside of wrestling that you're going to see them all go head-to-head. So it's kind of fun to get these games back into the schedule. But it's also nice to have games where we're not traveling 3 hours. But when we do go on the road to take them on here, next year we'll have both Oakley and Hoxie on the road. But, again, 15, 25-mile trips compared to our 3-hour trip last week to Hugoton, and their impending 2.5-hour trip to Ulysses coming up for later this week. So, that's always nice, too, to get a little bit of those shorter trips back onto the schedule. But the good thing about it, too, is, as you mentioned, you're not losing anything competition-wise. Hoxie and Oakley have been solid on the basketball side of things throughout that period. So, anyway, it's kind of fun to get these matchups back under the schedule. 5 minutes away from tip-off tonight. We'll take another break, and we'll come back and look at the starting lineup for these two teams. That's coming up after a word from our sponsors. You're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby Basketball on 100.3 The Ride.
When it comes to flooring and cabinetry in Northwest Kansas, the place to go is Northwest Kansas Decorating Center. They've been in business for over 39 years, serving the Northwest Kansas community with all their flooring and cabinetry needs. With many different types of flooring to choose from and cabinetry that allows you to pick your different wood and stain combinations, plus, of course, all the accessories to make it functional for you. See them today. Northwest Kansas Decorating Center, located on West 4th Street in Colby, for all of your flooring and cabinetry needs today. And while you're there, say, hi, Mr. Carey Turner.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, now with Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby. As part of the team at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic, I will not only be there to serve you and all your chiropractic needs, but will also be able to improve your health and well-being with acupuncture and Grafston technique. The Grafston technique breaks down scar tissue, helps in faster rehabilitation, and treats chronic conditions like joint pain, plantar fasciitis, and fibromyalgia. I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, inviting you to come see me at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby and start feeling better today.
It's too cold. Sound familiar?
If your thermostat wars and your utility bills soaring, see your Lennox dealer about a Dave Lennox Signature Collection home comfort system. Visit your local Dave Lennox Premier dealer, McKee Incorporated, located on South Range, right here in Colby. See your participating Lennox dealer for details. Lennox dealers include independently owned and operated businesses. Lennox. a better place. Cornerstone Ag is committed to the Northwest Kansas community because they're proud to be a part of it. At Cornerstone Ag, the staff works hard to be a local answer to all of your grain storage and handling needs, as well as a great local marketing resource. Their service is fast and friendly, with questions being answered on-site by their professionals. During non-peak times, they can even assist you with pickup and delivery services. Cornerstone Ag, where local customer service is not just a priority, it's the only way they'll do business.
Let Jay add pride to your ride at Motortown LLC of Colby. Always a fine selection of late model vehicles on the lot, including pickups. Two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, long box, short box, regular cabs, crew cabs, and many makes and models. You'll find sports cars, convertibles, luxury cars, vans, and of course the popular SUVs. Truly a great inventory to choose from, and as always, they're willing to pay you well for your trade. At Motortown LLC, located at 1275 West 4th Street in Colby or Ellis, Kansas. Go online to MotortownLLC.com.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Strut Insurance Services pregame show, the Eagles on radio here on 100.3 The Rhine. 2 minutes away from tip-off tonight between Colby and Hoxie. And time to take a look at starting lineups tonight for the two teams as they get set for this contest. Again, Hoxie comes into the ball game with an overall record of 13-6 on the year, and Colby 0-18 coming into the ball game tonight, and getting set for their final game of the season, regular season, coming up on Friday against Ulysses. Starting lineups here from the Eagles on radio, brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance agent Vernon Hurd. Offices in Colby and St. Francis. Starting lineup for the Hoxie Indians tonight, we'll go with Connor Cott. Cott is where's number two. He's a 5'9" senior. Also starting for the Indians tonight will be Josh Heim, the 5'7" senior, wearing number 10. Tyler Ewers will get the start as well for the Indians, a 6'1" senior. Easton Slipke will get the start, a 5'8" freshman for the Indians. And rounding out the starting lineup is Tanner Smith, the 6'5 senior. So four seniors and a freshman in the starting lineup for the Indians tonight. For the Colby Eagles, it'll look like this tonight. Chandler Comfort, the 6'1" sophomore, will get the start. Rex Branham, the 5'8" sophomore, will also start for the Eagles tonight. Leighton Reiner, the 5'10 sophomore, will start for Colby. Dante Whitfield, the 6'2 sophomore. And rounded out the starting lineup is Austin Ruff, the 6'2 senior. So four sophomores and a senior in the starting lineup for the Eagles tonight. Again, they will be without Ashton Russ. But it's at the community building, and it is a big crowd on hand for this contest. As we talked about, is Hoxie bringing a huge fan base over here tonight. And Colby, of course, with a big home crowd base as well. Hoxie will be in their visiting red uniforms with black numbering and white trim. Hoxie in white across the front with a black and white stripe down the side. And the Indian logo on the left-hand leg. Colby in the home white uniforms, orange numbering, black trim with a black stripe down the side. And the Eagle logo on the left-hand leg. The starting lineup being introduced to the crowd here at the community building. The Eagles running through the spirit line, getting fired up here before the game. A lot like the women's game in the fact that you don't want to get off to a slow start with this one tonight. You don't want to trail early and have to try to play your way back into it. You want to get off to a quick start and see if you can hang in there. And then the lineups have been introduced here, and the team will huddle up around their coaches while they anthem, and then we'll get set for tip-off tonight. We'll take one more timeout. We're back with tip-off of Colby and Hoxie coming up after this word from our sponsors. You're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby basketball on 100.3 The Ride.
Local farmers and businesses are the backbone of our community. They provide jobs for local people and supply our community with important goods and services. Here at Farmers and Merchants Bank, we invest heavily in our community for the future of the community. Last year alone, our bank participated and sponsored over 100 events representing over 50 groups and service organizations. If you ever wondered where your deposits go, just look around. Our name says it all, Farmers and Merchants.
together making a difference. We'd like to encourage you to shop and bank locally. Farms and Merchants Bank, member FDIC.
When it comes to flooring and cabinetry in Northwest Kansas, the place to go is Northwest Kansas Decorating Center. They've been in business for over 39 years, serving the Northwest Kansas community with all their flooring and cabinetry needs. With many different types of flooring to choose from and cabinetry that allows you to pick your different wood and stain combinations, plus, of course, all the accessories to make it functional for you. See them today. Northwest Kansas Decorating Center, located on West 4th Street in Colby, for all of your flooring and cabinetry needs today. And while you're there, say, hi, Mr. Carey.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, now with Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby. As part of the team at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic, I will not only be there to serve you and all your chiropractic needs, but will also be able to improve your health and well-being with acupuncture and Grafton technique. It's not commonly known that acupuncture doesn't just help with back pain. Acupuncture can help with many ailments, like infertility, arthritis, sinus issues, and allergies. I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, inviting you to come see me at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby and start feeling better today.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back as we get set for tip-off tonight. Jumping for Hoxie will be Tanner Smith, the 6'5 senior. Jumping for Colby, Dante Whitfield, the 6'2 sophomore. This is where the ball ready for play, and we're going to re-tip this one. I think he overestimated the jumping abilities of both players here at mid-quarter. That one was way too high. A little better this time, and Whitfield tips it over to Chandler Comfort. Colby wins the opening tip-off tonight. So the Eagles with it. Chandler Comfort will set it up. Hoxie going to start the game in a man-to-man defense. Whitfield swings it left side to Rex Branham. Branham will put it on the floor to Whitfield, top of the key. Dante driving, wanted to get it to Comfort in the corner, but lost the handle. It was stolen by Connor Cott. Cott up the floor, lays it in for Hoxie. Quick start for the Indians. They lead 2-0. They'll come out in the press. Colby breaks it as Austin West swings it right side. Three-pointer by Reiner. It's not going to go. An open look, though, and not a bad one. Rebound pulled down by the Indians. Colby into their 2-3 zone. And they don't do very many other things. Occasionally they'll drop into a man-to-man, but they let this off. And here's a great steal by Austin Russ. Knocks it loose into the hands of Whitfield. Eagles with the top of the key. Whitfield goes over to Chandler Comfort on the top left side. Dante right side to Reiner. Looking inside for Austin Russ. Nearly thrown away, but Whitfield runs it down and then has it stolen away as he tried to kick it outside. Easton Slipke came away with the basketball. So Hoxie with it now. The Indians will set up again, leading 2-0. With the ball on the top left side, Connor Cott guarded by Leighton Reiner. Brings it over on the right side to Josh Heim. Heim baseline to Slipke. He passes it off and the jumper up and no good by Tanner Smith, and the rebound pulled down by Whitfield, and now we're going to have a double dribble on Chandler Comfort. Kind of lost a handle on that dribble and ends up turning it over.
Hoxie comes out in a 2-2-1 full-court press. Really kind of slacking it off three-quarters court. Pick him up, try and trap him at the corners by the...
There's a drive by the Indian bucket's good and a foul. Trying to trap in the corners. Foul was on Austin Ross, his first team foul on the Eagles. And the free throw good by Heim, and now has 3 points. 5-0 in favor of Hoxie. 6 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. Colby with the basketball left side. Chandler Comfort, boy, he had time to shoot on that one, but going to set it up instead. Goes left side to Branham and goes in and out of Rex's hands, out of bounds, back to Hoxie. The Indians, with another Eagle turnover, will try to add to their 5-0 lead. Hoxie with the left side, open three-pointer, it was good. Knocked down by Easton Slipke. 8-0 Hoxie. Colby breaking the press this time. Branham right side to Reiner. Outside to Whitfield. Now to Russ, top of the key. Austin pulls up on a very long three. Comes up short, and the rebound pulled down by the Indians in the hands of Josh Heim. Hoxie up the floor. Connor Cott will set it out. Drives underneath, makes a great pass
to Tanner Smith, who lays it in. Colby going to take a timeout as they get the inbound pass in. And Coach Brown going to take a 30-second timeout here to make some early adjustments. 10-0, Hoxie off to a quick start tonight over Colby. Eagles really haven't had that many problems with the press, actually, tonight. Just not getting the shots to go on the other end.
Yeah, I think that's what Coach Brown's talking to him about. They're going to be able to here tonight to get that ball inside on this man-to-man defense that Hawks is playing in the half-court set. You know, get some ball reversals, things like that. Now, they're going to pressure you. They're going to be in your face all over the court, and that's where the back cut comes into play. And, I'm sure Coach Brown's talking about that to him during this timeout.
Eagles get it in. Taking it up the floor will be Dante Whitfield. Dante. Going to get a 5-second call here if he doesn't get rid of it. He does. The shot is up and no good. And he'll go to the line. Shoot a couple of free throws. Foul charge to Tanner Smith. His first. First on Hoxie. Whitfield, the lefty, puts the first one up and short. Dante will get set for his second attempt here. No good. Missed them both. Rebound pulled down by Hoxie, and they'll run it up the floor. Heim has it. Gets it over on the left side into the hands of Connor Cott. Cott will set things up here. Passes top left to Heim. Heim passes it off to Ewers, who gets called for the travel. So Colby will have it again off the turnover, trailing 10-0. Midway through the opening quarter here. Eagles across half court. Austin Russ with it. Over to Chandler Comfort. Colby with it. Comfort, right baseline. Pulls up on the three off the back of the rim. No good. Battle for the rebound. It's going to be over the back. Called on Austin Russ. Austin going to pick up his second personal foul. Over with the substitution here. Brooks Curry checks into the ball game. Dante Whitfield comes out. So Curry, Austin Russ, Ryan, Aaron Faber, and Chandler Comfort, the five on the floor for Colby. And Hoxie just going to drive all the way in, put up a circus shot on the lane by Cott. No good. Gets a rebound. His putback is also no good. And now Aaron Faber with the board for Colby. Gets it to Comfort. Chandler to set it up here for the Eagles. Top of the key to Faber. Boy, had a nice cut off of that, but Aaron did not see him in time. Now we feed it underneath to Brooks Curry, and he's fouled from behind. Good position there by Brooks Curry. Gets down by the low block. Gets Ewers on his heels on the back side of him. He's able to make a good drop set and draw the foul. Colby with it. It was the first on Ewers, second on Hoxie. Eagles driving baseline. Austin Russ goes for the shot. Draws the foul. This will be on Tanner Smith. It'll be his second. So Austin Russ at the line to shoot. Right hand, he puts the first one up and short off the running rim. Indians will put Peyton Taylor into the ball game, and coming out will be Tanner Smith with those two fouls. Taylor, a 5'10 junior. Second free throw. Also short by Austin. Hoxie with the rebound. Indians will take it up to four now. Just under 4 minutes to go in the opening quarter, leading 10-0. Hoxie with it underneath. Brooks Curry going to get called for going over the back. Curry with his first personal, third on the Eagles. Hoxie will have it underneath as Dante Whitfield checks in, and Austin Russ will come out with those two fouls. Whitfield, Faber, Curry, Reiner, and Comfort, the five on the floor for the Eagles. Hoxie with an open three on the right side. This one missed by Slipke. Rebound pulled down by Faber. Colby will take it up the floor. Comfort over to Dante Whitfield. Dante right side to Faber, looking in for Curry. Gets it to him. Brooks catches, spins, shot is up and good. Good move using his left hand by Brooks. Curry able to get the ball in about midway through the lane. Hey, if you're doing a most improved award, And Curry just gets a block on the other end, swats it away from Ewers. But yeah, Brooks Curry would be the man for the Eagles. Loses a handle on this one, though. He passes a little hard for comfort, and Hoxie will run the floor and lay it in. Josh Hine with 5 points. Hoxie back up by 10, 12-2. Colby with a long pass to break the press. Reiner out to Dante Whitfield. Whitfield has the ball kicked by Hoxie. Stay with Colby as Branham checks in and Reiner will come out. Hoxie will put Latham Schwartz in the ball game. Colby gets it in. Dante Whitfield to Rex Branham on the right side, looking in for Curry. Brooks catches and he's fouled immediately by Peyton Taylor. And Taylor, we're seeing a matchup problem here for Hoxie, especially with Tanner Smith out with those two fouls. Colby gets the inbound pass to Whitfield, now to Curry. Outside Comfort, left side Faber. Aaron, back out to Comfort. Chandler to Whitfield. Dante over to Faber on the left block, or left elbow, I should say, out to Branham. Now back to Faber on the left side, and it's out of bounds as Whitfield's passes a little off the mark. But all five Colby players are one end of the floor there for a second.
Yeah, the spacing so far for the Eagles tonight hadn't been great. Need to lose some guys back, and they're congesting. They're getting too many guys posting up on one side, just congesting the lane. They clear out, allow Brooks Curry to post up down there while he has to match up with Smith out. Things will go a lot better for him offensively.
Josh Hine gets a tough shot in the lane. 14-2, Colby trails. Three-pointer by Faber is no good. Rebound is a foul on the other end of the floor, and I believe on Rex Branham here. So the board was pulled down by Schwartz. Now it's on Brooks. And Curry with two fouls. Maznik will check in. Also back into the game, Austin Russ. Faber, Branham, Whitfield, Maznik, and Austin Russ on the floor for Colby. Hoxie with a basketball. Connor Cott passes it outside. This is a drive by Schwartz. Doesn't have it. Kicks it up, and here's a three-pointer. Top of the key, and enough of a net for Connor Cott. That ball was in the air for 6.4 seconds. High hop shot. Rainbow, there was nothing but net, and then Colby turns it over against the press. Back to Hoxie with a bad pass out of bounds. You saw that on the girls' game, too. They're afraid to shoot those high balls. Colby in the zone. Hoxie takes advantage. They kick it out in the corner. A three-pointer doesn't go for Ewers. Rebound out of bounds. Last touch by Ewers, so Colby will get it here. Hoxie will set up in the 2-2-1 full-court press. Colby looking on the left side. Rex Branham across midcourt to Austin Russ. Thought about the three. Gets it inside to Whitfield. He's fouled before the shot. This will be on the floor. Foul charge to Peyton Taylor, his second. Last year with Wade Niemeyer in the game, and Peyton Taylor will come out. Check that. That's Heim coming out. Eagles get the inbound pass in. Austin Russ fires up a three in the corner. Not good. Maznik's turnaround shot is also no good. And a rebound pulled down by Connor Cott for Hoxie. Cott on the run. Going to take it all the way. Missed the shot to draw the foul. Very aggressive take that time for the Indians. Fouls on Maznik, his first. Five on Colby. And Connor Cott will try to add to the 15-point Hoxie lead as he toes the line here. And puts his first free throw up. And good. Cott will get set for his second attempt here. Good. So 7 points for Connor. 19-2. Hoxie leads. Colby will break the press on the left side. Slayton Reiner, he'll drive in, and he's going to get bailed out with a foul call here. He's got a lot of control in there. He did the right thing when you're out of control in the lane. Just pretend to throw it up and hope for contact. So we'll shoot a couple, and the foul was the third on
Peyton Taylor. And again, he came in for Tanner Smith, who has two. There's a move of foul trouble underneath for Hoxie. The free throw is good by Lane Reiner. This is the first point of the game as Tanner Smith checks back in for Hoxie. Austin Russ in for Colby. Also in for the Eagles is Dylan Dumlin, 6 foot senior. Reiner's second free throw, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Hoxie's Tyler Ewers. Hoxie up the floor with the basketball again. Connor Cott has it knocked loose. Chandler Comfort runs it down for Colby. And Comfort will lay it up and no good. Foul on the rebound against the Eagles. Comfort up 7 himself. It's one you got to get.
Yeah. Great hands by Chandler. Defense has been just is able to convert the layup.
Foul was on Lane Reiner, his first. Sixth on Colby. Six, and they were trying to make him shoot free throws here, but not yet. One of the things for Colby here, too, is they really don't have a true point guard. You know, you look at that, especially against teams that are pressing you, it's tough to get it up the floor because it's somebody different every time. You know, they don't have that distinct role. Chandler's probably the better ball handlers out of that group. Hoxie with the basketball, drive into the lane, the ball loose, it's going to go out of bounds, nope, saved by Hoxie from going out of bounds by Ewers, but into the hands of Comfort. He swings it up to Austin Russ, he'll drive and miss the shot in the lane. And credit that defensively to Tanner Smith, who was posted underneath, and Austin had to go around him to try to avoid the charge, and that's what caused that miss.
And Smith not only tries to stand there and take a charge, he gets his arms out, making with a 6'5 frame, makes it a big target to try and shoot around.
Colby gets the inbound pass into Whitfield, who pulls up in the lane and scores. Dante with his first two, and that'll end the opening quarter. 19-5. Hoxie leads Colby. We'll take a break. Second quarter coming up after this word from our sponsors. You're listening to the Eagles on radio with Colby Basketball and 100.3 The Rise.
Technology is changing and is making banking easier than ever. Hi, this is Skylar with Farmers and Merchants Bank, and although we wish you could visit us in person, we understand that in today's busy world, sometimes it's difficult for you to make it to the bank. Luckily, we have just rolled out many new features: mobile banking, Hot Money, online bill pay, text banking, and mobile capture. So no matter where you're at, so is Farmers and Merchants Bank. Call us today for any questions about our new products at 785-460-3321. Together, making a difference. Member FDIC. Jay, add pride to your red at Motortown LLC of Colby. Always a fine selection of late model vehicles on the lot, including pickups. Two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, long box, short box, regular cabs, crew cabs, and many makes and models. You'll find sports cars, convertibles, luxury cars, vans, and of course the popular SUVs. Truly a great inventory to choose from, and as always, they're willing to pay you well for your trade. At Motortown LLC, located at 1275 West 4th Street in Colby or Ellis, Kansas. Go online to MotortownLLC.com.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back. Hoxie with the basketball to start the second quarter. And they get an open look underneath, but Connor Cott unable to hit. And the rebound pulled down by Comfort for Colby. Chandler going to take it right to the hole and miss the attempt in the lane. Don't mind the take, but got to get the finishes here. That's three for Colby, where he's at. Easy shots underneath or lay-in attempts that we haven't been able to hit. Hoxie with a carry in here, going to turn it over to Colby. Colby will get it in here to Austin Russ. Picked up by Heim. Russ gets it across midcourt for Colby. Austin spinning, kicking it outside to Comfort. Back inside. Now back to Comfort. Open for three. Get in. No, it doesn't. Rims out. Tanner Smith comes up with the board for Hoxie. Indians up by 14 with a basketball. Looking to get it underneath, and it's knocked away by Whitfield and out of bounds. Faber going to check in for Colby. Lane Reinert will come out. Faber, Comfort, Curry, Austin Russ, and Dante Whitfield. The five on the floor for Colby. Hoxie gets an inbound in, and the open look for three is good. Knocked down by Connor Cott. I'm telling you, these punters that wish they had that much hang time.
One more punch.
Some of these threes from Hoxie on both the men's and women's side. They like that high ball. It's
been good. Get me wrong. Colby gets an easy one on an inbound pass. His comfort left open underneath with an easy lane.
Yeah, Hoxie doesn't get set up offensively. The ref hands the ball in the favor, and he's able to make the easy pass into comfort for an uncontested layup.
22-7. Colby down. 6:33 to go. Second quarter of play. Hoxie with a basketball. A good pass underneath, and the shot no good by Tanner Smith. Whitfield with a rebound. Colby up the floor. Austin Russ underneath, fouled from behind. Mewers will pick up his second. 17 foul on Hoxie. Colby to shoot him. Asnick will check into the game for the Eagles. And Brooks Curry will come out. Austin Russ at the line. One-on-one opportunity here. This one's up and good. He missed his two previous attempts. So hit that one. First point of the night for Austin. He gets up for his second attempt. That one's no good. Rebound pulled down by Hoxie in the hands of Tanner Smith. Indians with it. Up the floor. Connor Cott swings it over on the top left side to Slipke. Now back on the right side. An open three. High shot, no good. Rebound and the putback is no good by Heim, but a foul call. Free throws will be coming here for Josh Heim. Magic picks up his second personal. Eighth foul on Colby. Seventh on Colby, excuse me. But two shots here for Josh Heim. First one's no good. Late Reinhardt in for Colby, and Austin Russ will come out for the Eagles. Second free throw attempt for Josh Heim of Kelly. It was good, but he stepped on the line. So a lane violation turns it back over to Colby. You know, you thought with these rules this year you would see less of those. You've actually seen a lot more.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. We've seen quite a few of those so far this season.
Some of it's just aggressiveness now that you can get in there after the ball leaves the shooter's hand. Faber for three for Colby. Eagles kicked it off in the corner against the press, and Faber knocks down a tough shot. Hoxie on the other end, and it'll be out of bounds. Knocked loose, and Heim couldn't pull it in before it went out. So back to Colby it goes. The Eagles have cut the deficit to 11. 5:40 to go in the second quarter, and a charging foul on the other end. Clayton Reinert running into Tanner Smith that time of late, and a little shaken up on that one. Clayton's going to pick up his second. Eighth on Colby, and Reinert's going to come out. Brandon will check in. 22-11 to score. Hoxie with a basketball. Caught. We'll get it in. Right side. Heim bounce pass inside. Shot goes up and it's blocked by Masnick, but he's going to get called for his third foul. Okay, with Masnick, we'll pick up his third.
Taylor's been good position defensively playing behind him. As Ewers brings that ball through, he just drops his hands. Doesn't keep his, he keeps those hands straight up in the air. He doesn't commit the foul. He's able to alter the shot. So.
Ewers hits the first free throw. He'll have another one. Whitfield coming out. Austin Russ back into the game for Colby. Free throw coming here for Ewers. Rattles in it. Timeout taken by Hoxie here. 30-second timeout. 24-11 the score. It's a 13-point lead for Hoxie. There's 5 minutes and 24 seconds to go in the second quarter of play. Eagles did a little better job here in this second quarter on the offensive end of things. And on the defensive side of things, they're doing better at taking care of the basketball.
Yeah, so far tonight, the thing that hasn't hurt the Eagles has been, you know, the press has been themselves offensively, you know, taking some quick shots, not really flowing in the rhythm of the offense. In the second quarter, they've done a much better job. It will get some more points on the board and cut it into this lead.
Halftime. halftime score on the Scott City Goodland game, 28-14. Scott City. On top of that. You remember last year, though, as Colby with it, here's a drive by Chandler Comfort. And he's going to get caught for traveling up and down. He's saying, no, wait a minute, it was knocked out of my hand. And they're just going to call it a jump ball. Going to call it a jump ball. And that goes to Colby on the possession end. So if you remember, Goodland had that big upset win over Scott City on their first ever conference loss, coming off of a K-State victory over KU in an upset loss in Manhattan. I don't think history is going to repeat on the second half of that. Three-pointer on the top left is up and good by Chandler Comfort. Or no good, excuse me, by Comfort. Rebound pulled down by Hoxie. Indians with the basketball. They'll drive on the left side, trying to get it underneath, knocked away by Masnick, but Hoxie runs it down, kicks it out for a three, and it rims out on the play by Slipke. The putback is there, though, by Tanner Smith, who has four in the game, 26-11. Colby will get it up the floor. Austin Russ crosses midcourt. Collins in a motion offense here. Austin will just drive for the Eagles, puts the shot up, no good. Rebound off of Austin's foot, out of bounds. Hoxie ball. Whitfield Curry and Reinert will check into the ballgame for Colby. In for Hoxie is Latham Schwartz. 26-11 the score. Hoxie with a 15-point lead, 4:10 to go. Second quarter. Connor Cott with it for the Indians. Behind. On the left side, Schwartz feeds it in underneath, and here's a spin move, and the shot up and short by Tyler Ewers. Rebound pulled down by the Eagles. And Whitfield will just run it up the floor for Colby and lay it in. And Hoxie with a timeout here to discuss things. Full timeout, we'll take it with him. 26-13, Colby down 13 with 3:45 to go in the second quarter. Back with more in just a minute.
It's time someone stood up for breakfast, the meal that sets the tone for your entire day. Hey, a soy latte isn't breakfast. Toaster pastry from a vending machine aren't either. Fluffy scrambled eggs, sizzling sausage, bacon. This is breakfast. And this is what's in Taco John's breakfast burritos, along with nacho cheese and golden potato olays, wrapped up like scrambled sunshine. They're the best breakfast burritos in town, only at Taco John's.
Taco John's!
The one-stop shopping in Colby, Kansas, don't forget about Colby's Walmart. Walmart in Colby has a great selection of grocery items in the store. From meat to macaroni, they've got it in the grocery department of Walmart. And, of course, all the latest movies on DVD or Blu-ray, as well as your favorite PlayStation or Wii games. Walmart in Colby also has clothes, dog food, and, of course, a pharmacy there to serve you as well. Walmart of Colby, proud to be part of the community and proud to support local high school student-athletes. For all your one-stop shopping, it's Walmart in Colby.
With more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Talking back out of the timeout, Hoxie with the basketball. They get it up the floor and a jumper on the left baseline. A quick one was no good by Josh Heim. Eagles come away with it now. And here's a turnaround shot by Whitfield. In and out, no good. Rebound pulled down by Brooks Curry. And had nowhere to go with it. Just called it a travel. Turns it over to Hoxie. That's just kind of an unfortunate one. Caught underneath, wanted to go back up, and then realized I'm directly behind the basket. There's not many players that can make a shot from there. Hoxie with a basketball inside, and Josh Heim with a pull-up jumper, giving him 9 points in the game. Hoxie back up by 15 now. 3:06 to go in the second.
You could make that shot.
Yeah, of course. I mean, that's about the only time the reverse mic and drill comes into play.
Eagles with it underneath. Curry has it go in and out of his hands, and it's knocked away, and it's going to be last touch by Branham before it goes out. And Brooks and Austin having words as they go up the floor here. Sure, just making some adjustments. Colby with six players on the floor. Austin will come out now. Only 13 to score. Hoxie with the basketball. Indians have it, top of the key. trying to get it inside. Curry knocks it away from Ewers, and the Eagles get the steal. So off the steal, Colby now has it. Layden Reiner hands it off to Chandler Comfort. Comfort to Branham. Now hits Whitfield, who had a nice backdoor cut, and Dante lays it in.
Great backdoor cut and good vision by Rex Branham. Able to see that from the wing. Makes a good lob pass over a Hoxie defender and hits Dante Whitfield for the easy lay-in.
Hoxie turning it over on the other end. His cot lost a handle on it. Branham came up with the steal. Gets it to Whitfield. Dante's going to drive in. Tries to pass it over on the right side. Just a one-handed pass, and Connor Cott makes him pay for that. Drives in, puts the shot up and good, but they're going to call a foul on the floor prior to the shot. And this is charged to Layden Reiner, his third. Layden with three, Masnick with three for Colby. Austin Russ and Brooks Curry each have two. 28-15 the score. Hoxie leading Colby by 13, trying to add two. It is Connor Cott to the line. Cott is 2 for 2 from the charity stripe in the game. Puts the first one up and good here. Telling you, these kids have been shooting over broomsticks. Second free throw. Good.
Cop's got a really high release. A lot of arch on the shot.
And all the kids seem to have that.
Yeah.
But I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
No, you're going to get a shooter's roll.
Yeah. Colby with the basketball here. Brooks Curry left side to Austin Russ. Faber, and he gets it to Russ. Now to Curry at the elbow, tries to drive, and he's tripped up as he goes up for the shot. And free throws will be coming here. Foul on the play, charge to Josh Heim. That's his first. Eighth on Hoxie. Curry just shoots two here. Actually, one on one here for Curry. So it came prior to the shot. Brooks hits the first free throw, but the free throw is waved off by the official. Actually, they're going to call a foul on Austin Russ. Trying to get position there. So we're going to shoot one free throw, and then we must have had a technical somewhere here. Curry misses the free throw. Then we're going to have the free throws on the other end for the fouls. I'm saying, see if they clear it out. So Austin, by the way, now with three fouls. He was trying to plead his case to the officials here. Tanner Smith to shoot here. One more. Whitfield will come in for Colby, and Russ will come out. And Tanner Smith will toe the line for his second attempt. And this one's nothing but net. Smith with 5 points. And it's back to a 15-point Hoxie lead. He goes to get it across midcourt. Chandler Comfort calling out the offense here. Picks up his dribble. Gets it to Whitfield on a backdoor cut. And a blocking foul called on Hoxie there. The backdoor cut's been there all day today. Hoxie starting to adjust, though. That time just got there a little late. Foul was on Wade Niemeyer, his first. Ninth on Hoxie. Whitfield at the line for two. His first one short.
That's something that's always going to be there if the defense overextends, plays that denial defense out above the three-point line. That's always an option to go with a backdoor cut. Chandler Comfort, Dante Whitfield read it there really well. Whitfield able to draw the foul and get to the line.
It's the second one after missing the first. Dante 1-4 from the charity stripe in the game. Score updates here again, 28-14. Scott City over Goodland at the half, and Hugoton leading Hugoton. Holcomb leading Hugoton, 35-25. That game also at the half tonight in men's action. Minute 18 to go in the first half here, 31-17. Hoxie over Colby. Indians with a basketball. Right baseline, a drive by Heim and a blocking foul on Colby. As they can comfort both in the area, let's hope it's on Chet. It is. Just a first on him. Masnick already had three, so he got one in to pick up his fourth here in this first half. And that free throw is going to be waved off by Heim. A high action shot. It took so long, and the kind of momentum carried him across the line, so they have to wave it off. Second one is no good. Rebound pulled down by Comfort. And Chandler will set it up here for Colby. Dante Whitfield. Right side directs Branham. Branham, top of the key. Faber into Masnick. Masnick back to Faber on the top right. Open three. This one no good. He hit earlier in the game. Rebound. Masnick saves it off the head of Connor Cott. Ends up in the fourth row after that. So it's Colby basketball. We will take it up the floor here. Chandler Comfort, nice spin move in the lane, but can't hit. Rebound and the putback rolls out for Masnick. We talked about it on the girls' side, and he struggles hitting those shots underneath, and the men are really struggling here tonight. They're getting opportunities. 27 seconds to go in the half. Scott City, or excuse me, Hoxie up 31-17, and now up 33-17 as Smith gets a little shot in the lane up and in there. Nice take to the hoop. 33-17 the score. Colby with the basketball, trailing. Masnick underneath, spin move, shot is no good. Another good opportunity, but unable to finish. And Hoxie away with the rebound. Connor Cott with the basketball, 2 seconds, half court shot on the way. No good. So at the end of the half, it's 33-17, Hoxie on top. We'll take a break. Come back with the start of our Cornerstone Ag Halftime Show. After this word from our sponsors, you're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby Basketball on 100.3 The Ride.
Farm Credit Western Kansas and Colby has once again returned $2.5 million of patronage to its members. In just the past 10 years alone, we have put nearly $20 million back into the area economy. At Farm Credit, we are proud to be the area's leading ag lender, taking an active interest in the success of our borrower owners. If you're involved in agriculture and not a Farm Credit member, why not? Call us at 1-800-657-6048 to find out the difference it makes being an owner. Farm Credit Western Kansas, financing ag for generations.
Hello, this is J.L. Evans, President of Western State Bank in Colby. We are a full-service bank with innovative products that you expect from your financial institution. We specialize in excellent customer service and competitive ag, commercial, and home loans. Check us out by calling, stopping by, or I will gladly come to your farm or place of business for your convenience. We are located just southeast of the Colby Walmart, right next door to the utterly delicious yogurt shop. Western State Bank of Colby, with bank locations throughout Western Kansas. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Colby Free Press brings residents of Thomas County news, pictures, and commentary on the happenings, issues, and events that impact the lives of residents of Thomas County. The Colby Free Press is informative and affordable. The Colby Free Press is a local daily newspaper that has earned a great reputation for journalistic excellence and extensive knowledge of the local communities of Colby, Rexburg, Brewster, and surrounding communities.
Stuck in a contract with a wireless company that doesn't care about you? Maybe you've been wanting to switch, but everyone in your family has different contract dates. Now you can easily say goodbye to your current wireless company. NextNet Wireless will pay your contract termination fees up to $350 per line when you activate a new smartphone with the Freedom Program. There are no service contracts and no worries. Certain restrictions apply. See store for details. NextNet Wireless. Say hello to something different.
Colby Free Press brings residents of Thomas County news, pictures, and commentary on the happenings, issues, and events that impact the lives of residents of Thomas County. The Colby Free Press is informative and affordable. The Colby Free Press is a local daily newspaper that has earned a great reputation for journalistic excellence and extensive knowledge of the local communities of Colby, Rexburg, Brewster, and surrounding communities.
Eagles on radio. Here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back to listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby Basketball on 100.3 The Ride. They have the halftime score of 33-17 in favor of the Hoxie Indians over the Colby Eagles. And
Look at this first half of play here. Again, kind of a slow start for Colby. Only 5 points in the opening quarter of play today. A little better in the second quarter as they're kind of settling in and taking a little better care of the basketball. Hopefully we can continue that here in the second half.
Yeah, in the second quarter they played great basketball. They would push the ball down the floor. You know, for the most part, the press really hadn't affected them too much here tonight. It's just the quick shots offensively to slow down, value the ball, get some good looks. I mean, they're getting great looks on the inside, just not being able to convert them. But keep going back in there, keep pounding in there with Brooks Curry, Whitfield, Russ, things like that. They're going to be able to get in this lead.
33-17, the scoreless run through scoring in the first half of the ball game for the Hoxie Indians. They were led by Connor Tye with 12 points in the first half. 9 points for Josh Heim in the first half of the ball game tonight. 7 for Tanner Smith. 2 points for Tyler Ewers. And 3 points for Easton Slipke in the first half of the ball game. For the Colby Eagles tonight, they were led by Dante Winfield with 7 points in the first half of the ballgame, 3 for Aaron Faber, 1 point each for Austin Ruff and Wade Ryder, and Brooks Curry with 2 points, and Chandler Comfort with 2 as well for Colby in the first half of the ballgame. Let's run through rebounding for the two teams.
Hawks is led by Tanner Smith with 5, Josh Heim 4, Latham Schwartz, Wade Niemeyer, and Connor Cott with 1 apiece. Colby's led by Dante Whitfield, 3, Chandler Comfort, 2, Caleb Mazik and Aaron Faber, also 2, and Leighton Reiner, 1 board.
33-17, the score at the end of the first half. We'll take a break and name our hot hand of the first half for the Eagles after this word from our sponsors on 100.3 The Ride.
This time of the year can get a little stressful on your finances. If you're in the need for any type of loan, come in and talk to their local Grown Loan Officers at the People State Bank. They live in this area, so they know this area. They pride themselves on getting you the fastest response possible. Since most of them have been in business or have come off the farm, they really do know the local ag economy. They want to take this time and thank you for your patronage at the People State Bank with locations in Colby, Oakley, Hoxie, Goodland, and McDonald. The People State Bank, member FDIC. Let Jay add pride to your ride at Motortown LLC of Colby. Always a fine selection of late model vehicles on the lot, including pickups. Two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, long box, short box, regular cabs, crew cabs, and many mix and models. You'll find sports cars, convertibles, luxury cars, vans, and of course the popular SUVs. Truly a great inventory to choose from, and as always, they're willing to pay you well for your trade. At Motortown LLC, located at 1275 West 4th Street in Colby or Ellis, Kansas. Go online to MotortownLLC.com.
This time of year, you'll be doing more traveling, loading up and heading out in the family truckster. Make sure you get to your destination safely. A Great Western Tire of Oakley and Colby. We have a tire sale going on now with Goodyear car, pickup, and truck tires. You'll find a tread and tire time for the way you drive, either down the highway or on country roads. At Great Western Tire, they offer service well after the sale, like free tire rotation. So take advantage of the Goodyear and other name brand tires on sale. Plus, their appliance sale going on now at Great Western Tire of Oakley and Colby.
With High Plains Co-op, it's great to know that the more things change, the more things stay the same. High Plains Co-op with locations in Hoxie, Dresden, Rainfield, Jim, Halford, Clark, Selvin, and in Levant. They're here to give you the service you deserve. High Plains Co-op is available for your grain, fuel, and feed needs. Check out their website at highplainscoop.com for up-to-date markets. Standing with you is High Plains Co-op.
Are you stuck in a contract with a wireless company that doesn't care about you? Maybe you've been wanting to switch, but everyone in your family has different contract dates. Now you can easily say goodbye to your current wireless company. Next Tech Wireless will pay your contract termination fees up to $350 per line when you activate a new smartphone with the Freedom Program. There are no service contracts and no worries. Certain restrictions apply. See store for details. Next Tech Wireless. Say hello to something different.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back. 33-17 to score. You're listening to the Cornerstone Ag Halftime Show. The Eagles on radio here at 100.3 The Ride. The halftime brought to you by Cornerstone Ag, there for your grain storage, marketing, and handling needs. See them today at Cornerstone Ag in Colby. As we look at our hot hand of the first half, which is brought to you by
the good folks at McKee Incorporated. Tim Parker, Carson, and the crew there for all of your heating and air conditioning needs. Might be time to get that air conditioning system checked out, as we're not too far away from the warmer weather, maybe.
We hope.
Yeah. So far, Punxsutawney Phil was right for a change. We've had that extra little bit of winter. Again, stop by and see them today. They can take care of you for your heating and air conditioning needs. And, of course, Great Lennox Systems and Service to go along with it at McKee Incorporated. Hot hand of the first half for the Eagles is Dante Whitfield. Nice first half for Dante. They won the opening tip-off. Leads the Eagles with 7 points in the first half of the ball game and 3 rebounds, leading them in that category as well in the first half of play. He's having a great start to this game. Dante Whitfield on McKee Incorporated. Hot hand of the first half here at 100.3 to Rock. 33-17 to score. The halftime show still taking place here at the community building. As the dance team joined by some of the high school guys as well tonight here. Kind of an annual event. They used to do this at the end of the year. And that taking place. Finishing up here, and then the teams will have 3 minutes to warm up and get set for the start of the second half of this ball game. Again, 33-17, the score. Colby trailing the Hoxie Indians. We'll take a break, come back, and get you set for half number two after this word from our sponsors. You're listening to the Eagles on Radio and Colby Basketball on 100.3 The Ride.
Quality workmanship and experience are just two of the things you will find when working with Stevens Construction for all your agricultural, commercial, and residential construction needs. They are your local Butler and Muster dealer and are ready to assist you in choosing the steel or wood frame building you have been looking for. They also specialize in overhead door sales and service. Stevens Construction has been in the business for over 40 years, so stop by today and see them on South Country Club Drive in Colby. Since 1994, Office Works and Home Furnishings in Colby has been offering solutions for your home and office needs. And while they still continue to do that, they also specialize in something else. Comfort. Office Works and Home Furnishings is a proud retailer of the Serta I Comfort beds with optional adjustable bases. Plus, on top of that, they're the only Lazy Boy Comfort Studio in Northwest Kansas. So if you're looking to make your home more comfortable this year, make sure you stop by Office Works and Home Furnishings on South Range in Colby.
Be ready for whatever tasks lie ahead with a Case IH Maxim tractor from Colby Ag Center in Colby. Thanks to multiple engine, horsepower, and transmission choices, plus great options, you'll be ready to handle anything from tending the livestock to roadside mowing. But even as different as each Case IH Maxim tractor can be, there's one thing that makes them all the same, and that's their exclusive efficient power and proven SCR technology for greater fuel efficiency with lower emissions. See Colby Ag Center about a Case IH Maxim tractor today.
It's Ram Truck Month at Colby Dodge, and we are extending the Truck Month savings to you. If you're in the market for a new Ram truck, you can save up to $9,000 off MSRP this month at Colby Dodge. We also would like to invite you to test drive the all-new 2015 Chrysler 200 and take advantage of 0% financing up to 60 months with approved credit. Visit us in person at exit 53 I-70, Colby, Kansas, or online at ColbyDodge.com.
This time of the year can get a little stressful on your finances. If you're in the need for any type of loan, come in and talk to their local grown loan officers at the People State Bank. They live in this area, so they know this area. They pride themselves on getting you the fastest response possible. Since most of them have been in business or have come off the farm, they really do know the local ag economy. They want to take this time and thank you for your patronage at the People State Bank, with locations in Colby, Oakley, Hoxie, Goodland, and McDonald. The People State Bank, member FDIC.
Now, with more of the Eagles on Radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Substate, welcome back. You're listening to the Eagles on Radio in Colby Basketball on 100.3 The Ride. 33-17 to score, Colby. Colby trailing at the end of the first half. Getting set for the start of the second half here tonight. Hoxie will start the second half of the basketball. Eagles will go with Branham, Reinert, Comfort, Austin Russ, and Dante Whitfield. They'll start in the 2-3 zone here in the second half. Hoxie with the same starting five, and Connor Kottheim, Ewers, Hipke, and Smith. And try to get it underneath to Smith, but Reinert able to get a steal for Colby. And Chandler Kupp are going to get called for a carry here, second time around. Turning it over, so back to Hoxie. Indians will inbound here on the sideline. Set it up on the top left. Skip pass over on the right side to Josh Heim. And trying to get it in underneath, and it's stolen away again by the Eagles. Whitfield came away with it. Colby up the floor, Austin Russ. Devontae Whitfield wanted the backdoor shot, wasn't there. Whitfield kicks it outside to Chandler Comfort. Back to Dante. Brings the ball down, has it knocked loose, and we're going to end up with a foul call on Hoxie. This one charged to Josh Heim. Dante's got to be where he gets that ball at the high post, keeps that ball high so a guard like Heim can't come through and swipe that thing out. Colby had it here. Chandler Comfort was driving baseline, but had his ball knocked out of his hands and out of bounds. Scott City Boys, 65. Goodland, 35. Final score tonight of that game. Hugoton up 10. Holcomb up 10 on Hugoton at the half. Tonight, 35-25. Another GWAC action. 33-17 to score here. Hot seat leading Colby. Indians with the basketball and a jumper in the middle of the paint. It rims out for Tanner Smith. Rebound safe for going out of bounds by Heim for Hoxie, but into the hands of Chandler Comfort. Comfort up the floor for Colby with it. Again, has it knocked away from behind. It's going to go out of bounds, though, and off the foot of Chandler Comfort and two Hoxie as it was knocked away by Connor Cox. 33-17 the score. Hoxie will take it up the floor. Caught with the basketball. Passes it off in the left corner. Now a lob underneath. It's caught by Ewers. He doesn't have a shot. Drives out. Resets the offense. Heim kicks it in the corner. Open three. This one's short. Little off the mark by Slipke. Battle for the rebound. And it's going to be out of bounds to Hoxie. Holcomb leading Hugoton. In the start of the fourth quarter. Hoxie with a basketball. Skip pass, top right side. This is Josh Heim. Tries against the tree. Three, tries to hit the cutter going through. Reinert steals it for a second, but is going to go out of bounds. So he threw it behind his back. Hoxie ends up with it. And then a great move here by Tanner Smith to get Austin Russ in the air, and then Dutch under and scores. As good a head ball fake as you're going to see. Colby with it on the other end. Whitfield trying to get the Eagles on the board here as they trail 35-17. Gets it over to Comfort. Chandler underneath to Whitfield. Back out to Comfort. Now to Russ, left side Branham. Good job of reversing the offense around this time for Colby. No shot there. They'll skip it up top of the key. Comfort right side to Austin Russ. Trying to hit Whitfield cutting through there, and Dante can't hang on. Heim comes away with the basketball for Hoxie. Indian setting it up. Heim passes it outside to Connor Cott. He'll drive in. Shot in the lane. Rim it around and good. Cott with 13 points in the game. 37-17. Hoxie up by 20 now with 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter tonight.
Hoxie's still in their man-to-man defense. Probably having trouble setting up.
Whitfield tried to go in and had his shot swatted away from behind by Tanner Smith. Hoxie trying to convert on the other end. The original shot was missed by Ewers, but Connor Cott with the putback to give him 16 points after getting the board. 39-17. Scott City leads. Sorry, just getting hot. Scott City score update. Dante Whitfield pulls up on the jumper for Colby. It's good. Two. And then a timeout taken by the Eagles. A full timeout. We'll take it with them. 39-29. Colby down 23 in the third quarter with 4:25 to go. Back with more in just a minute.
Count on Kansas Quick Lube. Every time you come in, we change your oil, check your tires, wipers and bulbs. Everything your owner's manual recommends. You got expert technicians who all know how. People keep their cars much longer now. So maintenance is a must.
show. So let us take care of your automobile. Calvin Kane's a quick move. Our name says it all.
Hello, this is Rock Medora with Homeland Realty and Auction in Colby. The local market is very strong, and we are aggressively out looking for ag land listings. We are geared up to handle your land sales by private treaty or public auction. With 30 years of experience, I am very passionate about my work and willing to offer the expertise that you deserve. Stop by our office at 1055 South Range here in Colby, or give us a call at 785-462-8255. It is truly a good time to sell. Homeland Realty and Auction, where we still offer good old Western hospitality.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back. Hoxie had the basketball, but Austin Russ steals it away from the Indians as he gets it from Easton Slipke, but then on the other end of the floor, Slipke knocks it away from Austin before he can get to lay it. It ends up out of bounds, and Colby has the ball. Random gets it into Chandler Comfort. Surprised I haven't seen Curry here in the second half. I thought he played really well, and especially in that opening quarter. I got a couple of fouls in to go to bed, but he was playing well early and getting some good post-ups underneath.
Yeah, it really was the answer for Smith in that first half until Smith had to go to the bench with foul trouble himself. But he really played lights out both offensively and defensively. He was altering a lot of shots in the middle of that 2-3 zone.
It was a nice drive by Lane Reinert. He has 3 points in the game. He takes it around on the left side. Here's Curry getting set to check in. 39-21, Colby down 18. 3:42 to go here in this third quarter. Hoxie with the basketball, an open three. Good. Knocked down by Connor Kahn. Kahn with 19 in the game now. 42-21. 21-point. Hoxie leads. They've doubled up the Eagles with 3:25 to go here in the third. Colby has it. Reinert gets it underneath to Austin Russ. Spins in the lane. Shot blocked. Second block by Tanner Smith in the game. And then Smith trying to get rid of it to Connor Kahn, and they end up turning it over to Colby as Austin Russ got the steal. But then when Russ got it, his foot was on the sideline out of bounds. So still ends up in the hands of Hoxie. Eagles get it up there. Hoxie gets it up the floor. An open three-pointer on the left baseline is off the mark by Tyler Ewers. Rebound pulled down by Dante Whitfield. Colby hustling it up the floor. Faber underneath to Curry. Spin moves. That shot's up and good. If he catches it, he has a great little drop step and finish. And he hits it almost every time, especially to that left.
Yeah, he's got a really good left hand on the inside.
Hoxie gets it underneath this time. The turnaround shot in the lane is not going to go for Tanner Smith. Good defense by Curry. And Colby trying to hustle it up the floor. Hoxie had two defenders back there. It hits one of them in the back of the head of Josh Heim and ends up in the hands of Connor Kahn. And here's Heim from the left elbow on the other end. No good. Rebound. His position was Brooks Curry, and he was fouled by Latham Schwartz. First on Schwartz. Second foul of the half on Hoxie. Austin Russ will check in for Colby. Dante Whitfield will come out. Colby gets the inbound pass in. Austin Russ will take it up the floor for the Eagles. Cross midcourt looking left side for Blaine Reinert. Doesn't have that. Kicks it over to Chandler Comfort. Comfort trying to get it in underneath. It's tipped and knocked away by Connor Kahn. Hoxie with the steal. Kahn up the floor for the Indians. Takes the shot in the lane and misses. Rebound pulled down by Curry. Gets it to Comfort. Chandler will set up the offense. Right side to Faber. Now over to Comfort underneath to Curry. Again to the left. And the shot's up and in there. 6 points for Butch Curry in the game. Hoxie will drive on the other end. Heim has it knocked loose. Reinert comes up with the steal. Colby with some numbers here. Layton takes the pull-up jumper and knocks it down to the right elbow. 5 points for Reinert in the game and a timeout taken by Hoxie. We'll take it with him. 42-27. Colby down. 1:16 to go in the third. Back with more of the Eagles on radio and Colby basketball in just a minute. Stretch yourself.
protect your home and business and the stuff that you love.
When it comes to insuring your home, vehicles, and valuables, don't just insure your stuff, strut your stuff. With Strut Insurance Services of Colby, located just west of Casey's Convenience Store and their store in Brewster. See their ad in the next tech directory.
We'll take the risk.
Are you running on empty? Service Oil Company in Colby is the place to fill up. Hi, this is Monica with the Service Oil Company. We feature quality Conoco gas at prices that are hard to beat, and we have a great selection of snacks and drinks inside to fill you up. Service Oil Company is focused on bringing you quality fuel at the best prices possible. Come by and experience the difference for yourself. Service Oil Company is open weekdays 8 to 12 and 1 to 5, with pay at the pump open 24/7, located at 4th and Court in Colby.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back. Hoxie with the basketball out of the timeout, leading Colby 42-27. Hoxie with it on the left sideline. Get it in underneath. Some new players out there on the floor. Niemeyer with it to Peyton Taylor. Back out to Niemeyer. Now in the corner, Slipke. Skip pass left side. Caught, open for three. No good. Bounce off the space station. We'll get the rim. It was high arching shots from the Indians. Colby with the rebound. Eagles will set things up. Aaron Favor to Austin Russ. Austin underneath to Curry. To the left, spins and scores. He's the unstoppable force for the Eagles here in the second half. 8 points for Curry. Hoxie with a three-pointer on the other end. This one will not go for Slipke. Curry with the rebound. Colby gets back. Good job by Austin Russ, beating the defense of Hoxie back. And Austin lays it in there. 3 points to Russ in the game. And at the end of the third quarter, Colby's closed the gap to 11. 42-31, the Eagles trail. Fourth quarter coming up after this word from our sponsors. You're listening to the Eagles on radio and Colby basketball at 100.3 The Rise.
With spring around the corner, there is no better time than now to head into the sports shop in Colby and get yourself set for the spring sports season. Travis, of course, has everything you'll need, from spikes to thrower shoes for the tracksters to the bats, balls, gloves, and cleats for the baseball and softballers. Plus, going on all March is his March Mayhem Sale, where they've got great deals on everything, plus a portion of the money goes to benefit the American Heart. So make sure you stop by and get set for your spring sports season today at the sports shop in Colby.
Defend, rebound, pass the ball and score. Basketball is simple. Insurance is too, when you turn to me, Farm Bureau agent Vernon Hurd, in Colby and St. Francis. I'm your go-to agent for auto, home, life, and business insurance. So no matter what life brings, you'll be ready with a game plan that meets all your coverage needs. Talk to me, Farm Bureau agent Vernon Hurd, today. I make insurance a layup.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wieland.
Welcome back, Eagles with the basketball. Out of the timeout, starting the fourth quarter. 42-31, Colby trailing Hoxie, with the Eagles have been on a little bit of a run here in the second half. Doing it in the paint. Eagles get it into Brooks Curry, but it's knocked loose by Hoxie and stolen away. Indians with the basketball. They'll set it up. Connor Cott driving on the right side. Curry knocks it away, and Branham gets a steal for the Eagles. Swings it over to Faber. Now inside to Curry again. The double team coming, and the pass was knocked away. Hoxie with the basketball. Indians have it. Connor Cott kicks it over on the left side. Here's an open look at three, and this is a little bit short by Ewers. Rebound pulled down by Chandler Comfort for Colby. Comfort left side to Austin Russ. Long three. No good. Rebound pulled down by Ewers. Well, Hoxie back with it. Colby getting ready to make some mass substitutions here for the next stoppage. And we're going to get it here as Austin Russ is going to pick up a foul. And that's going to be four on Austin. Coming out. Eagles will put Clayton Reinert into the ball game. Caleb Mazzig checks back in. Dante Whitfield in there as well. On the floor with Branham and Comfort. Inbound passes in and a quick foul on Mazzig, who now has four. Not even a second off the clock there. Caleb picks up his third. Hoxie gets the inbound pass in. They'll set things up. Top of the key into the hands of Connor Cott. Into the lane, now underneath, and shot up and good. Nice finish by Tanner Smith. He is 11 for Hoxie.
A good high-low by Hoxie, and that's something that's tough to defend. That 2-3 zone, you really got to hedge down if you're a guard and trying to help out your big guys so they can rotate down and take care of that guy in the low block.
Colby trying to get it inside to Masnick that time. It's knocked away and out of bounds by Hoxie. So Colby will inbound under their own goal. Reiner catches. Gets it into Whitfield. Whitfield left side to Chandler Comfort. Now to Whitfield and Dante Travel. Got his feet moving early. So turnover back to Hoxie it goes.
And when Colby got on that run up there at the end of the third quarter, they had really good spacing offensively. We were able to get the ball on the inside, let Brooks Curry and the other big guys work. And so far here, starts this fourth quarter, they've gone away from that. The guards have tried to go inside and post up a little more. It's really congested the inside.
Take by Hoxie's Connor Codd, draws a foul. And that will be the fourth on Madison. Connor Codd's going to shoot two here for Hoxie. Codd is 4-for-4 from the charity stripe in the game with 19 points on the night. Now 20 as he knocks Allen down. Austin Russ will check in and Mazzik will come out. Russ also with four fouls though. We'll have to be careful. We're still 5:57 to go here. Second free throw. Good. So Todd hits them both. 21 points for Connor in the game. 46-31. 15-point Hoxie lead with 5:50 to go in the fourth quarter. Colby with the basketball. Austin Russ off the screen. Drives and can't get the shot to go, but does draw the foul. And we'll get set to shoot a couple here from the free throw line.
And a good take by Austin. Gets the screen out there on the elbow extended. The free throw line extended, excuse me. And he gets a wide open lane in the basket and takes it. They will get to the line.
Foul was called on Heim. It was his third personal. Hoxie has to take Ewers out of the ball game as he's got a little blood on his leg there to cut some sort that they got to deal with before they put him back in. Austin Russ, the first free throw up and good. 4 points on the night for Austin. 2-5 from the free throw line in the game. And now 2-6 as he misses that one. Rebound battle for, and it'll be out of bounds off of, well, they're going to call a foul on Colby here. And this may be the fifth on Austin. It is. So Austin is fouled out of the ball game. Abel and Curry check into the game for Colby. So Austin fouls out with still 5:42 to go in the game. Hoxie with the basketball now. Underneath, it's knocked away and out of bounds. Last touch by Tanner Smith, so it'll be Colby ball. Hoxie will put Troy Burris into the ball game. Colby with Whitfield, Curry, Comfort, Reinert, and Faber on the floor. Down to with it for Colby driving in. As it knocked loose, comes up with a loose ball and scores. And then a timeout taken by Colby. Just a 30-second timeout. Whitfield into double figures for the first player for Colby to do so tonight with 11 points in the game. The 30-second timeout by the Eagles. Colby still with two fulls left. Hoxie has a full of the 30 left. Scores 46-34. It's Colby hanging in there. Again, got it down to a 12-point ball game. And getting some looks on offense right now.
Yeah, they really are doing a nice job of getting inside. Getting some good looks from down low in the paint. Hopefully, Boston has found out with so much time left in the fourth quarter, that doesn't come back and hurt them.
Especially when you have some other players in foul trouble, too, for Colby. Still a lot of time left, 5-10 to go in the ballgame. Hoxie with it in the paint. They were trying to get it inside to Tanner Smith, and it was tipped and stolen away by the Eagles. Chandler Comfort up the floor for Colby to Faber on the right side. A three-pointer, no good. It's his own rebound. Good hustle by Faber to run that one down. Colby with it left side. Chandler Comfort into Curry. Back outside to Reinert. Open three, short. Rebound pulled down by the Indians in the hands of Troy Burris. Passes it off and a running jump in the lane. Good by Connor Kyle. Kyle with 23 now in the game. 48-34 the score. Colby with an open three by Faber. Knocks this one down. Second of the game for Aaron Faber. He's got 6 points tonight, and now Colby with another timeout here. Full timeout by Colby. We'll take it with him back in 60 seconds with one of the Eagles on radio and Colby basketball 100.3 to 1.
The country flooring and cabinetry in Northwest Kansas, the place to go is Northwest Kansas Decorating Center. They've been in business for over 39 years, serving the Northwest Kansas community with all their flooring and cabinetry needs. With many different types of flooring to choose from and cabinetry that allows you to pick your different wood and stain combinations, plus, of course, all the accessories to make it functional for you. See them today. Northwest Kansas Decorating Center, located on West 4th Street in Colby, for all of your flooring and cabinetry needs today. And while you're there, say, hi, Mr. Carey Turner.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, now with Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby. As part of the team at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic, I will not only be there to serve you and all your chiropractic needs, but will also be able to improve your health and well-being with acupuncture and Grafston technique. The Grafston technique breaks down scar tissue, helps in faster rehabilitation, and treats chronic conditions like joint pain, plantar fasciitis, and fibromyalgia. I'm Dr. Mark Gunlock, inviting you to come see me at Northwest Kansas Chiropractic in Colby and start feeling better today.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back. Coach Gable, athletic director extraordinaire, does it all, including sweeping up some debris off the floor there before they come out of the timeout. Got a rousing applause from the crowd here at the community building. Colby battling in this game, down 11, 48-37, 4:23 to go here in the fourth quarter. Still plenty of time for the Eagles here. Got to take care of the basketball. Hoxie doesn't. Branham gets the steal for the Eagles, gets it over to Faber. His shot in the lane does not go. Rebound pulled down by the Indians, now knocked loose again, and it's going to end up out of bounds off of Colby. A good job there by Connor Cott of throwing that off of one of the Eagle players. Colby putting some pressure on, and Brooks Curry checks back into the ballgame for the Eagles. Brandon comes out. Oh, I thought that was Hoxie basketball.
I did too.
Eagles with it. Curry underneath. Shot is up and no good. Rebound pulled down by Connor Cott. Cott will run it up the floor for Hoxie. Lobs it over on the right side to Heim. Back underneath. Down to Cott at the free throw line. Knocked loose. And jump ball called. It will stay with Hoxie on the possession area. Colby starting to play with some confidence here. Hoxie gets the inbound pass in on the right side. Feed it in underneath, and there's a drive, and Whitfield knocks it off the foot of Ewers and out of bounds. Back to Colby, it'll go. Curry gets it into Whitfield. Right side to Chandler Comfort. Now to Dante, who's across midcourt. Takes a shot in the lane, no good. But then knocks the rebound away. Gets it over to Faber. Faber goes for the shot, and Tanner Smith puts it into the wall. Third block for Smith in the game. Well, we inbound into Brooks Curry. He drives, shot is off the rim, no good. Good look, he just got a bad roll. Hoxie away with the ball. Indians on the left side and drive to the hoop. Open lane that time. Good move by Ewers.
He's got four. Now to a 13-point Hoxie lead, 50-37, and here's a steal by the Indians. Haim got it, feeds it over to Cott. His shot is diverted by Curry, rebound by Whitfield, but Dante has his pocket picked from behind, and then Leighton Reiner runs into Connor Cott. Both players hit the floor hard and slide. Foul called on Reiner. Fourth on Leighton. Hoxie back with it. Indians in the top left side. Haim to the left elbow. The jumper knocked down there by Ewers. 6 points in the game now for Ewers. 52-37 to score. Colby with it. Brooks Curry. Long jumper on the way. Good. Curry for president. Playing great tonight. 10 points for Brooks. 8 of them here in the second half. And he has really done a great job of getting Colby back into this game. Eagles down, 13. They try to feed it underneath, and Curry knocks it away from Tyler Ewers. Hoxie, inbound pass in here. Connor Cott sets it up, gets away from Branham, drives, and it's blocked by Curry. Branham comes away with a basketball. Over to Chandler Comfort, an open three. Good. Chandler knocks it down. And then Colby takes their final timeout here as the Eagles trail by 10 with 2 minutes to go. Back with more after this word from our sponsors and 100.3 their own.
It's too hot. It's too cold. Sound familiar?
Before thermostat wars send your utility bill soaring, see your Lennox dealer about a Dave Lennox Signature Collection home comfort system.
Visit your local Dave Lennox Premier dealer, McKee Incorporated, located on South Range, right here in Colby.
See your participating Lennox dealer for details. Lennox dealers include independently owned and operated businesses. Lennox. A better place.
Cornerstone Ag is committed to the Northwest Kansas community because they're proud to be a part of it. At Cornerstone Ag, the staff works hard to be your local answer to all of your grain storage and handling needs, as well as a great local marketing resource. Their service is fast and friendly, with questions being answered on-site by their professionals. During non-peak times, they can even assist you with pickup and delivery services. Cornerstone Ag, where local customer service is not just a priority, it's the only way they'll do business.
Now, with more of the Eagles on radio, here's Chad Jones and Thomas Wheeland.
Welcome back. Hoxie with a basketball out of the timeout. They drove on the right side to Connor Cott in a hurry. Whitfield trying to get in front to draw the charge, but didn't get his feet set in time, and that'll be the first personal on Whitfield. Seventh on Colby. Two free throws here for Connor Cott. First one's up and good. 24 points for Connor in the game. Seven for seven from the charity stripe. 8 for 8. 25 points. 54-42 to score. 12-point game. Timeouts were kind of a curious ones here for Colby with 2 minutes to go in the game, and you're coming back, and now we've used two timeouts in the last two possessions, and we are out for the game. And now the momentum changing a little bit here. Hoxie with another steal, and Chandler Comfort with a quick foul. He's got his second and his team foul. Actually, that's a fourth on Chandler. So we're kind of surprised we used those that quick, and then now, you know, if the tide turns here and Hoxie gets some momentum, we're there to stop it. Free throw good by Haim. 10 points for Josh in the game. And no. Second one bounced on the rim several times, but ended up falling out. Pulled it away with the basketball, and we're going to have a foul on Hoxie. If you're Hoxie, the one thing you don't want to do at this point is foul.
Yeah.
Lipke would be first. No one Colby has any opportunities to score without the clock moving, even though it's just the fourth team foul. Eagles with the basketball, Leighton Reiner, right side to Chandler Comfort. Looking underneath for Curry, too high, stolen away. Hoxie with the basketball. time. Somehow keeps a dribble there, despite fouling, gets it out to Cotton. His shot from the free throw line, no good. Rebound out of bounds off the foot of Chandler Comfort. So Hoxie will inbound under their own goal. With a minute 13 to go and a 13-point lead. Passes in. Colby with the basketball on the left side. Cott. Passes it off to Josh Hines. Skip pass on the right side to Slipke. Now Cott. Guarded by Branham. At to Slipke. Left side Hines. Hoxie working the clock here. Under a minute to go now. 54 seconds. And Dante Whitfield with a blocking foul. Second on Dante. Ninth on Colby. One-on-one here for Hoxie. And I'm 2 of 5 from the free throw line tonight. It was a free throw up and no good. Rebound pulled down by Curry. Colby up with 4 of the basketball. Leighton Reiner driving. Charging foul. Good job, Kendra Smith got set in there. Reiner has fouled out of the game with that one. Colby was getting ready to put seniors into the game tonight here for the Eagles on senior night. So again, Colby has 6 players on the floor with Cameron Comfort runs out, but they'd already inbounded. It should have been a technical on the Eagles. Faber on the floor. Chase Eggert on the floor for Colby. Masnick is in there. Dylan Dumler is in the ball game. Ezekiel Baca in there for Colby. So again, you got the seniors in there right now for Colby, with the exception of Austin West, who of course started the ball game. Eagles with it underneath and goes out of bounds. Last touch by Eggert. 18 seconds to go in the game here. 13-point lead for Hoxie. Indians will have to get it across midcourt and we'll just try to run it out from there. Connor Cott. So we're on the ball handling display, kicking it off in the corner. Off to Heim now. Baca tries to get it from.